Short falls and little sins. Close calls when no one wins. Stand tall but running thin. I'm wearing thin.
Good.
Oh.
47-minute video. Here we go.
Why we keeping score? Cause if you're not laughing, who is laughing now? I've been wondering if we...
This is good news. So good. We've been up all night long. Flew across to Papua and we're in Tamika now. Finally getting on our little last plane before we actually land in the tribe, which is exciting.
So Ty and I were looking for a third partner in crime to join us on this adventure, and we got Nate Perry to join us, who's a friend of Ty's from high school.
You ready, bro? Ready? Come on, dude.
The little blue envelope has a white plastic bag if you get airsick.
Yeah.
If you use the white plastic bag, it becomes your souvenir from MMA.
Get it. Let's go.
I think this is clear for takeoff.
Going, baby.
That's it?
That's it right there.
I can't see it.
There he is, the man, the myth, the legend.
So John was the one who invited us over to help him with this construction project. He's actually Ty's father-in-law. He's been a missionary here for over 30 years, and he grew up here. He actually helped the tribal people build this runway, which makes it a lot easier for people like us to come over and help.
Amakale!
What's up, man?
How's it going, guys? Yes,
how are you?
Good to see
Sean,
you.
This is Sean. Yes. That's Nate.
Nice to meet you, man.
Other ladies, huh?
Good to see you guys. Man, you made it in the middle of mud.
Yeah.
Seriously, it is. We've got a mud wrestling thing all worked out.
So we safely landed in Pogapa, which is the name of the village. And under the instructions of John, he had about 500 of the Moni people working about 8 hours a day for an entire year to get this runway to be able to land a plane. And all of the rocks and dirt and everything that was moved was all done by hand.
Well, Mom and Dad were missionaries, got here in December 1950, and so I grew up in this area from the time I was two, and as a high schooler, God began to speak to me saying, you know, you really, if you do what I want you to do, you'll go back and work with this tribe.
The one we're building.
The building.
What's it going to do for you or for people?
Okay.
Or...
What is going to happen is this building is going to be a place where teams, church teams and others can come and help in ministry, help run some of the leadership seminars, help some of the youth programs that we have going, be people that come in and teach some of our teachers how to be better teachers here. So I don't have enough room for all these people at my house, and so this will be an overflow.
You built this house 30 years ago?
Yeah, when Jenna was born.
We're on to something. We're already starting with the battle wounds too.
Yeah,
Ty Nelson.
Ty Nelson Grossman, what can I do for you? Yeah, boy, we are in the we're in the dregs of day one.
The next floor is gonna start. We're gonna rip this whole roof off, maybe tomorrow, maybe today, if we get to it. We're gonna cut all the way around there. Have a 7.5-foot ceiling. Go up a whole nother floor.
Nothing all day.
roof is already off. Making a little bit of progress.
Woo-wee.
Big man, come on. You guys are very strong.
So here we are inside the actual building, underneath. We got here, coming over here, we thought we were not going to have any power. And days before we packed up to head this way, we found out that we would have a generator. So we get here and we start setting up, start plugging in our tools and find out we're actually pumping 220 volts through our 120 volt tools. So our tools are going nuts and they're not working. We have a brand new chainsaw. The chainsaw is not working. So day one and two, we're struggling. We're actually doing what we thought we'd be doing with handsaws, and so it was a rough start. But we got, as you can see, we tore off a roof, and we got our new floor joists on here. And today is Monday, and we're ready to get going.
We do have some of the flooring in there.
Yeah. So it has been raining, like it's been a mess. And they said it's been raining way more than normal. So we got a big tarp, and Sean had the idea to put this beam across and kind of make a little roof over it. And we've put it up and taken it down probably 4 to 5 times already. So most of the wood that we use for the joists for the new floor, some of the boards we're using for the actual flooring is a little bit softer, but most of the joists and the wood that we're using was cut out of this tree, which is an evergreen tree. And it's proven to be extremely, extremely hard. So a lot of the nails that we've been using and trying to put in, we've been having repetitive issues of bending nails and, you know, a real difficult time trying to get those put in. So that's kind of been one of our big challenges, you know, over the last couple of days.
What we've got here is we have no 110, we have no 220 right now. So we're taking a solar panel, we're putting it into a 12 volt battery, and then we're taking an inverter that takes 12 volt and turns it into 110. And so that 110 is then what we're charging the drill here.
This is amazing, because look, this is our magic.
That's right.
That's our magic little number right
it's
there.
It's doing it, it's charging. And we're using the sun to charge it.
I know, how amazing is that?
We're almost done with the flooring, huh?
Yeah, we're getting there.
Need a little 16th of an inch off. Can you handle that, Ty?
You're not going to do it.
Scoot it this way a little bit. Let's see what we got.
Yesterday, and today it looks like we are going to build some trusses and put up a roof is our dream.
Sean, how many times have you pulled out a nail, do you think?
Every other man.
Or Nate, how many times do you think you pulled out a nail?
Today?
No, in 4 days.
Well, today I think I may have got like one or two actually in all the way, smoothly.
Rest. What do you think about that?
I think it's good. About that. It's good for building character.
Yeah, seriously.
Trusses, baby! I love to work and nothing all day. And I've been taking care of business every day. Taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business. It's all right. We're up on top of the world! Care of business. Woo! Take it.
So we got to go to church on Sunday, and I had an opportunity to share my story while John translated for me. So after church, there was an argument that broke out between the people of the church and a cult called the Breakout Group. Apparently, they had been causing a lot of trouble in the area, and much to my surprise, they were there because of us.
These guys are trying to shut down the project and trying to, they're saying, and these guys are saying, you have nothing to do with this. You have nothing to say about this. We're the ones that are calling the shots. They said, even the government's telling you that you're not even registered. He says, you're just going around burning people's churches, making like this. There are people that have started this cult, you know, or joined this cult. And the whole cult is to just get money and to rip people off and take over people's churches and put their...
So later, I asked John if we had to be worried about them setting the project on fire, maybe even trying to shoot us with arrows while we were working. And he said we probably wouldn't have to worry about that. He doesn't think they have the guts to do that. So being in a completely new environment, I didn't find that all that reassuring. But I think I was the only one looking around to seeing if they were around while we were working. But a few days later, we got to meet someone who put us all at ease.
Threatening to stop this project.
Yeah.
And I'd like to ask him what exactly he told them.
He said, I told him, yeah, you guys are causing a lot of problems down here. But he said, if you dare try to come up my way, he says, look at my arrows. He says, I got them all ready for you. He says, even if it's more than one of you, he said, I'll put an arrow in every one of you. Don't even come up here. And he said, in fact, if you're going to come up here, he said, bring some pigs and some shells, because you're going to have to pay for what happens once I kill you. You're going to have to pay for the fact that I used my arrows on you and stuff like that. So just come up ready to pay for my arrows and everything. Well, this means I'm going to kill you when you put your thumb up somebody's nose like this. He says, yeah, these are my arrows. Take a look at them. This is what's going to do you in. You're going to be dead.
Well, you could tell him that we said thank you for, you know, the protection, yeah, and looking out for us, and, you know.
Okay.
Look at this. Is that ginger?
That's a gumbo. It's a single. It's a type of a potato.
We are heading down to get on the chopper, man. This elusive chopper that we've been waiting for a while is coming to pick us up and take us to Tomosiga.
Tomosiga.
The airstrip that's been being built for 30 some years, and it's still not landable.
Workers, if there was an emergency, there would be no way to get them out to a hospital. You're pretty much, without an airstrip, you're pretty much stuck in the jungle.
Yeah.
So an airstrip is critical if you want to try to open up an area.
decides to jump out of a plane.
Check it out with Mike.
Here?
Hey, I'm Mahe.
Guys, I'm gonna just keep
It's just a sweet shot. This guy's missing his finger. John up there, he's telling them things they need to do to be able to get this thing moving forward.
Just know about one meter, you can tell.
All right, here we are on top, getting these purlins all laid out. This is what it's like up here. We've got some pretty gnarly wood, some pretty gnarly, a handful of real full-on nails here. So we're getting after it, just about to start this roof.
Is there like a word for cool?
Ezogol.
Day five of work. We poured some footers.
Find a little flat.
Four posts for our deck, all on the same day of getting that roof on.
Closing in on the roof, as you can see. We are going to put in some plywood here in a minute.
Herman's killing the siding here. Just doing an amazing job.
And Herman actually helped build the original structure back there.
We got help over here putting siding on. We got one room with plywood and majority of the windows.
I don't know what the day number is, but it is the final day of work. We head back to Bali tomorrow. As you can see, we got most of the siding and all that stuff up around the back. So the last things we're finishing, we got one more room to plywood. Ty Grossman down there is going to work on the bathroom. He's going to put his fine touch on those wonderful things.
We're going to somehow rev a toilet and a sink and a shower all in this space. It's actually a pretty big bathroom.
You know what? It's going. Kind of sick of doing plywood. But
custom mahogany finish here on the vanity top.
You guys are rocking and rolling over here.
Okay, we're coming to the very end of this job. And Nate is wondering if it's a success.
If we left one day earlier, we wouldn't have gotten this project done.
That's true.
I dig it.
Can you dig it? His name is Goody. He
likes to use the drill.
Isn't that Kung Fu Fighting?
And his name is, what's his name? Darius?
Darius!
Is that it?
Darius!
Darius. And his name is...
Thomas.
Darius! He likes to fight so well with the bad guys!
Oh, he's almost...
Yeah!
Yakumena!
Modern rustic style, shiny windows.
It looks awesome. Final product. How we feeling?
I think it's awesome.
I think the rooms are big.
Can you come right here?
Woo!
Everybody was kung fu fighting.
This is the first break of the day, like courtesy of Sean Goodrich. He had to have his coffee and donuts.
Finally, I get my coffee break for the first time ever.
This is the kind of day Nate's having, I guess.
That is the kind of day I'm having.
We haven't even had the inspector show up yet.
Some people have Mike that live with them as roommates. Some people.
I got salamanders.
This is Nate's little friend right here. He carries around. Pick up your chin real quick. His little friend.
What is it?
Little butterfly moth thing.
It's like a tripping hazard, or is that just part of the architectural feel?
Poor friend, the salamander.
Yeah, he stinks.
That's OSHA approved right there.
Here we go.
We needed a workout today, huh? Come on.
Get that out of my face.
So I don't know why we let Ty Grossman fly this plane, but obviously he didn't do a good job. It's laying here in the mud.
We went the organic route this time.
Yeah. But no.
Rolly bag status right here.
Nate has lost so many bags in his life.
Is there going to be refreshments on this?
Yeah. Hey Nate, are you in business class up there?
I am.
Oh sweet.
More likely on the way to the airport than actually at the airplane. Is that right, Tigra? All right.
Thank you, sir. Yeah, thank you. Last time, I will try for the next flight.
All right, thank you so much. We'll see you.
We were a little delirious towards the end, but I think it was just because we missed our families.
What are you girls up to?
No, I just
good.
I'm asking you, Lord, but you please draw near to open my eyes so that I can see how you are. Working in me, all I need is love to come and fill this heart of mine. My heart is a desert that is gonna dry, and I need your love to get me by. All I need is love to come and fill this heart of mine. My heart is a desert that is gonna dry, and I need your love to get me by. grab me by. I lay down my life and I put it before you, and I put all that I have to lay in your hands. They're not gonna question to the why you're so faithful, to the why that you give me the blessings that you do. The glory be known, the glory be shown. I just lift you up onto the sky. Na 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 na.